All right, how you doing? I'm Jerry Basterman from Propellerhead Software, and we're really excited because today, June 21st, is the day we release Reason 9 right here at Sweetwater Sound. So couldn't be more perfect to show you what it's all about. Anyway, Reason 9, we approached this in a couple of different ways. One was, how do we furnish people with some extra ways, extra easy, fun ways to get ideas? You know, where do you get ideas anyway, right? Where do they come from? Sometimes they come from sounds. When you're browsing a sound bank and you come up with that sound that you just start playing, a song is born. And sometimes it's other things you have in your mind. We have a brand new way we think it's going to help people come up with songs really easily, or loops or whatever. And we call them players. I want to show you what they're all about. So I'm going to open up, let's just say, scales and chords. We name the players to be very clearly what they are, right? This is about scales and chords. If you check out what's on the screen here, I have any key that I want and any of these modes or scales, from minor to major to any of the modes, Mixolydian, Dorian, Phrygian, harmonic minor, chromatic, etc., pentatonic. You get to set that up. So let's say it is C major, and I start playing the sound. I'll play a C major chord. Obviously, that's very easy. What if I start playing these notes that aren't in C major? Okay, well, besides the clicking of my nails, you don't hear any bad notes, right? Because that C sharp that's not in the key of C is not playing, it's playing a C. I can change the filtering process so it doesn't play anything at all, but the main idea is you can't play wrong notes. If I'm in minor, you can't play wrong notes. Anything you play is going to be in that scale. So that's the notes part of this, right? Let's keep it in major for now. The chords part comes in when you see this number of notes here? Let's raise it to 2. And what it's going to do on top of this C is add a third. Okay, that's like, right, very simple. What if I want to change the inversion so it's not a third, but rather a sixth? But I'm just playing one note with my hand, with my finger rather. So the idea is it's really easy to come up with harmonies. Now what if I play a couple of notes? I'm coming up with keys and chords and that I just wouldn't dream up at all. And what if I now change the inversion back to 1 and the notes to 3, we get our triads. C major chord. Right? But that's kind of like bunchy. It's like going like boom, boom, boom. If I say open chords, now sounds more like a string arrangement. So now, person like I that doesn't know how to maybe arrange strings for my new ballad, my new song that I'm working on, I can just let scales and chords help me. I can further expand it by hitting octave up and octave down. Still, I'm playing one note. So if you record this into a MIDI track in Reason, then you're recording just that one note you're playing. But when you have something that you like and you come up with a part, you can use these features up here, direct record, send to track, to spill all that material onto the track. So everything you're generating now will appear like MIDI notes, and you can just edit them per normal. So it's a really exciting, easy way to generate great sounds. And as you turn up this chord knob to 4 notes, you get more jazzy chords with extensions. And finally, the last one gives you 5 notes. Okay, that's scales and chords. Now, let's bring up another file. I want to show you Note Echo. We named these so bone simple, you know exactly what it does. So if I ask you right now, what does Note Echo do? It echoes the note you play. Let's check this out. I have a little drum sound here. Let's go down an octave. Has this quick repeat. I don't want it so quick, so I'm just going to take a step length and raise it. Okay, but that sounds sort of like monotone, and I'd rather have it be either that it's getting louder, look at the velocities there, okay, or turn it down so it's like going away. And if I have less steps there, less repeats, Okay, so you can dial up all kinds of things. Let's say I go to another preset, and octaves, let's say, and we're gonna go to a synth or piano sound down here, right? But the step length needs to be a little longer. So now there's a little bit of a delay between the octaves that are playing. I could go to an octave down. Okay, there's a lot of things you can do. You can program pitches as well. So if I turn this pitch on, okay, and we're gonna have the pitches go up, and now I'm gonna include the number of repeats, gonna go up. So now we have a kind of a roll up. That's happening really quickly. Let's just change the step length. Like that. So you can have a lot of fun playing with note echo and maybe come up with an idea or an effect that you can use in a song. That's the whole idea, is like to discover new ways of playing with sound. That's note echo. And now we're gonna check out the dual arpeggio. There's three players that come with Reason 9, and the dual arpeggio is a beast. For one thing, it's not just one arpeggiator, it's two arpeggiators. Let's turn one of them off. For another thing, let's turn these guys off. And let's just... Okay, so I have one octave playing, so I'm not... Right, if I turn on velocity, now it has a lot of accents that are coming in, sounds a little cooler. See those green notes? You can draw them in and make patterns. So it's not just an octaver, it's actually a little trigger. You can actually build rhythms into this. I can change the, I can shift so it starts in the middle and wraps around that way. Let's see if I change the octave. Now it's gonna repeat it up there. And now I'm gonna turn the second arpeggiator on. So you get these polyrhythms, because with two arpeggiators, they can be different lengths, they can have different accents in them, and it means that everything you do like that. Super, super fun. And again, when I'm recording, I can either record the notes I play, or up here, direct record, send to track, I can have them appear on the MIDI track, and then just edit them like normal MIDI data. So you can populate your track with cool sounds, music, edit some of it out, and then build on the tune that way. So that's dual arpeggio. Another thing we wanted you to do was be able to sound really good. And how do you sound really good? Well, we already have the model of the SSL console 9000K in the software. That sounds great, right? With the EQ and the gate and the compressor, all very good sounding. Our 1,000 new sounds in the sound bank, done by expert sound designers, all these amazing combinators that are all controllable. Everything in Reason is controllable. Those make you sound good. But we have a new pitch edit feature you're gonna love. I'm gonna open up a file here. It's the demo song, actually. Let me just open this demo song. And you'll see how you can take some vocals and really, well, make them sound perfect. Okay, so let's just listen a little bit to this track. It's called Street Phone. There's a little bit of nothing on the intro. And we're gonna be able to edit the pitch of these vocals. Okay, so let's go to the vocal track.
Oh, now get your freak on. $7 billion street phone. Oh, now get your freak on.
Okay, we're gonna concentrate. Here's the analysis right here.
I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here. And I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here.
This is the analysis of that singing, right? And it's in this graphical mode, so you can track it. Now, when I start moving these things around, I can hear what I'm doing because There's a little sound connect, a little synth sound that tells me what pitch I'm on by ear. There's these handles. This handle here is going to reduce that vibrato of, well, you can't really see that well. Look at this. What he does with his voice, I can reduce that. I can flatten out that vibrato right there if I want to. I actually kind of like it. I'm going to leave it there. These lower handles, you know, people don't sing immediately from one note to the next, right? If you got a crooner like Harry Connick or somebody, you're going to, almost crossfade from one note into the other. It's not portamento, it's just this smooth move. And that is tracked by the analysis as well. Now I can control that. I can say, I'd rather not have that. See the way that crossfade region disappeared. Or I can make it grow and have there be more of that. So in every way, from timing to these little subtle changes of expressivity in a vocal, I can get what I want. And I can, in fact, it sounds so good because it's part of our tempo change algorithm. The other side of that in digital audio is pitch change. So we have this great tempo change algorithm that allows us to change the tempo of a song easily with digital audio. Well, this is the pitch edit side of it, and it sounds just as good as the tempo change does. So I'm going to try something that probably you should not necessarily ever do, which is just to change the notes. Let's say I change my mind about what the singer should have sung, or I want to make a variation. So let's just listen again to what this does.
And I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here. And I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here.
Okay, goes way down. And I'm feeling like when I'm mixing it, yeah, it's a cool variation, but I'm losing the voice because he goes down. I'm going to actually go and bring him way up. Da 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 ha. Right? Now, you shouldn't be able to do that. I know that's what you're saying. You shouldn't be able to do that. And I can tell when I get there because I'm going to be able to hear it with the synth sound. Now, that's quite a change. That's an octave of a change for that note. So let's just check it out.
Blood suckers in here. And I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here.
Yo. Pretty amazing. I mean, normally you can create a duplicated track and maybe do thirds, harmonies, and you can create those. They sound exactly like the voice. But here I just changed it an octave to just show you that, yeah, maybe I want to go in and raise the level a little bit because voice got airy there. But the quality is beautiful, and it's just as expressive because I left all that vibrato in there. So anyway, that's the pitch edit. It's a really new high-end way to treat your vocals and perfect them and make them perfect. So you're going to sound great. Another thing we got in Reason 9 that's really exciting. Well, the first part of it's called Bounce in Place. It allows you to take any MIDI clip that you have with whatever automation and whatever effects are going on it. Maybe you have the players on it. But you hear when you play that clip a certain sound. When I invoke the new feature Bounce in Place, it replaces that clip and everything else, the effects and everything, with an audio file, right in the same place in your music. So you can move on. You've already developed that, right? Well, the opposite of that would be to have an audio file go to MIDI. We call that audio to MIDI. So let me just, I have some examples I want to play for you. This is another way to sort of get inspired, right? If you're using our iOS apps that allow you to capture, like record something on the road, and you say, hey, this is a cool bass line I should use someday, and you go boop, boop, boop into your phone. You use our cloud service to bring it into Reason. There it is in Reason, and you can say, well, let me do the MIDI from that so I can assign it to some synthesizer. So here's a good example. Here's a bass player playing. Sounds like electric bass to me. And now the MIDI version, down an octave, right? So that's, I just assigned it to the subtractor default patch, which is a bass guitar. Here's Tobias Freiber. Yeah, turn off that bass. Here we go.
What a day. I don't know where my feet would take me.
All right, and let's just hear how that turns into MIDI. Yeah, it just tracks it really easily. Last example is going to be this Fufu's saxophone sound. Man, that's not MIDI. You know that. So let's go back and turn it into MIDI and actually keep the sax on. I got a vibraphone sound that sounds really cool with it. Stuff like that. I mean, you can just play all day and get these ideas, build them into your music. It's a lot of fun. So that's reason 9 in a nutshell. You got players, you got the graphical pitch edit, you have audio to MIDI, lots of workflow changes. Also, Pulsar, which is a $50 rack extension that we made a couple of years ago, is now included with the software. It's a dual LFO, can actually become an FM synth if you hook it up a certain way. That comes now native with Reason 9. Again, 1,000 new sounds. So there's a lot in Reason 9 that you can enjoy, and we're happy to introduce it here at Sweetwater on day one. We just went live with it. So if you have any other questions about any other Propeller Head products, please talk to your Sweetwater sales engineer, and see you next time.
Get your freak on. $7 billion street phone. Oh, nah, get your freak on. Hey, hey. And I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here. And I can tell you, there's some cold blood suckers in here.